everyone. This is Adel from Ozen Engineering. In this video, we will explore the EMA3D cable shielding effectiveness of a box demo, which is available in software examples. So let's consider this simple geometry, which consists of a box with a small aperture. Our first objective is to set up the problem space, then proceed with the EMA3D cable workflow. This workflow will allow us to model the interaction between a plane wave and the box, enabling us to analyze the inside electric field and determine the box's shielding effectiveness. Here in the discovery interface, located in the top left corner, we have the structure tree. This tree contains all the individual components of our geometry. Down here we have the stage explorer. To access the EMA3D stage, you can click here and select EMA3D from the available options. Once we are in the EMA3D stage, we will proceed with the EMA3D workflow. To begin, click on the EMA3D tab located in the ribbon at the top. Next, click on the domain button. This will open the simulation tree, which displays all the different steps of the EMA3D workflow as we progress through them. The simulation tree also allows us to edit any of the steps as needed. Now let's go to the properties panel and expand time and lattice, minimum and maximum. Let's keep the stability margin to 15% and adjust the lowest and highest frequencies. We set the lowest frequency to 10 megahertz. And as you can see, adjusting it will automatically adjust the end time. We set the highest frequency to 500 megahertz, and this will automatically adjust the step size in both time and space. Now we need to ensure that all pieces of the geometry that we want to mesh are encapsulated within this lattice. So the box should be entirely encapsulated by the lattice with a little bit of padding between the boundary and the model. Here in the properties panel, we set the boundaries. Let's consider minimum X minus 420 millimeters, minimum Y minus 420 millimeters, and minimum Z minus 1920 millimeters, maximum X 1920 millimeters, maximum Y 1920 millimeters, and maximum Z 420 millimeters. Once this is done, let's click on the green checkmark, which completes setting up the domain.